So, I got an email last week from Chen from nototo, and he let me know about this product that was essentially a SimCity-like note-taking application. And you know me, I jumped over to Product Hunt and decided to check it out. It got first product of the day in start of January, middle of January, and the essential idea is that it's a visual way to note take. Now, if I'm honest, I sort of jumped on this straight away because I thought this application could be great for students, but also if you're teaching your kids productivity or some sort of note taking system, or you're a visual learner, and obviously it's suitable for sort of all parts of those. So in today's video, we're going to check out nototo. We're going to sign up and give you a bit of an overview of the application. Okay, folks, so here is the landing page. The price is free at the moment. You can donate to them. This is by some lentils. Apparently, they're three engineering students. Which is quite cool, sort of a bit of a startup idea at the moment. And we're just going to sign up here. Okie dokie, so here is the onboarding. What I quite like about this is they sort of like have built, I guess, some sort of thesis around this. Like, we all have superpowers, and also that our minds are almost like recall centers, like a mental map. So you can essentially build stuff inside of this application. It sort of reminds me of like RuneScape to some extent, like I don't know, or like Age of Empires, sorry, not like RuneScape, Age of Empires. So for example, what you do here is go ahead and create an island. So I'm actually quite impressed with the speed of this on web. It is a little bit snappier than what I expect it. So when you start an island, you could, for example, call it history for, you know, AS level, if you're in the UK, that is. So here you can start taking your notes below. And as you can imagine, you can use all of the text formatting that is available here, including actually adding some images, some multimedia, as well as some links as well. So in this case, you could talk about, you know, your coursework that's coming up. And if I actually get out of this note, I can see that these sort of 8-pack of notes is created from this island. Now, if I click into this, I could like recolor the note straight away, or actually that recolors the entire island. But I can go ahead and create a note within this sort of history A level. Now, what's quite nice as well, you can remove this from the grid, which is essentially taken off. So you can just take that off. And as you can see, the island gets slightly smaller, but you can also relocate it. So you can bring it from one island to another, which is quite nice. And they do also say up here, tip, shape your island into different shapes to make it more memorable. So for example, if you are, I don't know, studying the history of Italy, you could shape it into maybe a boot or very similar to what you could do. Now you can also delete the island as well. You can recolor the island at any time, as I mentioned. And all you have to do to make that island bigger is just keep pressing these sort of new squares. So navigation seems to be fairly easy. As you can see here, there's sort of like a tutorial on the left-hand side. It looks like I've expanded my island, and what I can do is place a note here, and that checks off another. So I might say here, coursework A, and you can see here that I've gone ahead and edited that note. We'll come back to the note editing a little later, but as you can see here, it wants me to expand the note. I'm not exactly sure how to do that. Maybe that's this resize option. So once you go ahead and press resize, you can make it a little bit bigger so that maybe it takes up more space. Say you're studying something that's a little bit more specific, you can make it very big, or this is for an exam, for example. So that's one of the things there. Now, one thing you can do is you can use the right click to actually expand your island there. I'm curious at what placing a component means. So if I were, for example, to create another island, you can see that that one pops up. So you can put down decorative components and they act as mental cues. So here we go. So you can access your components up here. So for example, let's say I wanted to relate this one to history to make it a little bit more associative of history notes. So maybe that boat could be quite good. So I'm going to pop the boat over here. I'm guessing you can drag it. Okay, so that took a little bit of time for me to understand, but all you have to do is click it, and then actually you have to just sort of make it a little bit bigger. So you could do that with all of your different notes. And for example, if I had, the study of the Apollo missions, that was part of a class topic, I could go down to space. And what I could do is move one of the phases over to it drag that there. So that on that seems like a ship. So you get the concept. You can start adding these sort of basic elements to it. It's quite nice, actually. I'm actually surprised at how much of a range there are here. For example, you could be studying biology and the way that food and energy works, and you could grab that. So it's quite nice. And they're actually called, I don't know whether you've watched, Sherlock, the series, that he uses these sort of mental maps to essentially create associations in his mind. And this, I guess, is the same concept. So if I went over here, there's these things called templates. Now you can choose some of them, like for example, with journaling. So for example, if you wanted to steal a March 2020 template, you could go ahead and zoom out and drag that one in and just tap it. So as you can see here, it's quite cool. So you can actually go in and start writing a journal. I think this is a really neat idea, actually. This is, without being discriminatory, unless you're a visual thinker, this could be a quite good way for kids to start journaling or even getting into productivity. It's almost like a stepping stone. Or if you're a visual thinker and you want to start tallying everything up. So they're what the templates do. And you can actually get a template for different types of months. So if I wanted to start, plotting ahead and seeing, okay, up here along this sort of right-hand line, you can see that April is available and also March is available, but you could go ahead and create your own island if you want to. Now, as you can see, there's sort of a limit to some extent. Let's see if you can actually... Okay, so there's no sort of limit to it. You can zoom out as far as you can, but it doesn't look like there's some sort of ending to this whole map. It's like a clean canvas. So you can build roads to your island as well, I believe. So for example, if you wanted to build some sort of associations, I'm guessing I could build some roads to it. So as you can see, I've tried to build some sort of roads. I'm pretty awful at this, but the concept it would be to help connect up between islands. And again, it's a sort of a bit like Notion. You could probably get a bit carried away in terms of building your own structure. Now going back to the note editing, you can create as many notes as you like. You can also go and color them individually. For example, if I wanted to have a green note here and a blue note here, maybe not blue, maybe a white note, then you can do so. And you can add as many notes as you like by the looks of it. Inside the note editing, you can also add checklists. So for example, if you got some homework, you could go below and start using the checklists, which are easily tickable. And you can also use some of the quoting, the number checklists, bullet points as well. So some of the minor things, I believe up here you can undo and redo, but there's also this option, if you use two fingers, you can scrabble the entire map. So if you had quite a large map, you can move around quite well. Now on this left-hand side, if you open it up, you can actually get a sort of a bit of an overview of where your different areas are. And for example, you can skip to them. So for example, if you built quite a hefty area, then you could actually go and find it using the navigation bar on the left. They've also got settings as well. You can select the colors you had, the trackpad mode, and the scroller sensitivity. You can also export your notes as well, which is fairly good, into a zip file. And there's an option to buy them a coffee below. Now, I can definitely see why this application is currently really popular on Product Hunt. I really love the idea. And if I had a kid that was, say, between 10 and 15, and they were looking to start school and, looking to take more sort of effective note-taking and actually build a practice of active recall, then I would recommend this application. It's quite cool. But also, if you're a visual thinker as well, if you're someone that demands a bit of association, if you're studying and researching, or even you want to journal and spice things up a little, and you're very visually thinking individual, and Notion is not doing it for you, this could be quite a nice alternative. But guys, This was just a short review. I'll be keeping an eye on this application. It's a pretty cool one. And hopefully this review helped you out. So please do let me know in the link in description. So please do let me know in the comments below what you thought of this application. And I hopefully will be reviewing applications like this in the future. So guys, make sure you have a great day. And I'll talk to you very, very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.